But let me just tell you this. Even the chain places that are only in New York, okay, and I won't name names because I don't want to disparage my city. But there are chain places that are local to New York. Even those
now, all of a sudden,
even those places, you know what I mean. The local chains, they're not that good. It's okay, okay. It's okay. It's fine. It's passable. Now you have a set of stones on you that you're going to come in here and think that this bread, sauce, and cheese concoction can hold a candle to lasagna. Ravioli.
My favorite.
Manigot. Rigatoni in a meat sauce. Spaghetti.
Linguine and clams.
Pasta fra diavolo. Are you out of your mind?
Carbonara.
If you went to the middle of nowhere, this is the last thing I'll say, then you can speak again.
Okay. All right. Hold on. Let me just adjust my attitude for where you're bringing this. Okay.
Okay. Let's go now because
I told you, babe. I'm ready today. Let's go.
Yeah, go. Please talk.
Let's go. Yeah. All right. I'm just saying, if you went to a restaurant in the middle of nowhere, let's say, like you were in the depths of Wyoming, right?
Yeah, because this is relatable to people.
No. Let's just say. Yeah. Okay, a place not known for pizza. Let's put it that way.
You're calling out something like Ray's Pizza. There's 100 locations in Manhattan and saying it sucks. But then you're like, put yourself in my shoes. You're in the middle of the woods in Wyoming.
But you're not. You don't know where I'm going with this.
Please.
You're in the middle of Wyoming. Let's say. Okay. You go to a restaurant. They go, we got two dishes here. We got pizza. We got pasta. Which would you like? You know you're going with that pasta. You know there's no way in hell you're rolling the dice on that Wyoming
pizza.
No,
I don't know if I'm dealing with that pasta.
Bullshit.
I mean, dude, I could make pizza right now. I go downstairs, get a pizza. Here we go.
Every week, I could go downstairs and do this right now.
All I mean is, go ahead. English muffin. Like, if you have a jar of salt, man, a nice jar of Rao's sauce, shout out Rao's, a nice bag of shredded part skim mozzarella, and even an English muffin. I go downstairs, I have the three hallmark ingredients, I toast an English muffin, throw a little sauce and cheese on it, throw it in the oven for 5 minutes. That is delicious.
Sure.
That is pizza. Yeah, That's how accessible pizza is.
But you also just pick the ingredients yourself. I'm talking when you are at the mercy of another person.
Yeah, it might be bad crust.
It.
I know, but I'm also scared of what's in that pasta. Because
stuff in the pizza crust.
Just a sauce and a pasta and that's it?
If they said we've got a thing of Kraft Parmesan cheese that comes in the green tube, right? And they said we got a box of mama whatever the hell it is spaghetti, okay? And we boiled it and we got some ragu in the back. I would take that over the dice roll pizza any day of the week because that pizza, there is so much that can go wrong. I'll tell you another thing with pizza. Pizza is one of the only foods I can think of where if it gets bad, it gets terrible. And if it gets too good, it gets terrible. Pizza, if you go too far in the artisan direction, it stinks. Stinks. Somebody comes out and goes, well, we've got a caramelized raspberry reduction on this pizza, and we've got a candied mushroom.
When it no longer becomes pizza, that's fine. But that's not really true because there's a market for that. And I've had good artisanal pizza. But look, if I'm in Wyoming,
where?
I'm going for the pizza. Many places. I'm in Wyoming, I'm going for that pizza. Where? I'm not going for ragu and boxed pasta.
What you're
going
to get the same ragu on the pizza, and it's going to be worse on the pizza than it is on the pasta.
Why am I arguing about a small town, side-of-the-road restaurant that has a menu with two items on it? Take it to global.
There's a reason
why. Take it to a global thing.
There is a reason why. Hear what I'm about to say to you. There is a reason why you could go to almost any state in this great land of ours and find multiple great Italian restaurants. And why, when it comes to pizza, there's four neighborhoods you can go to get it. You can go to New York. You can go to Philly. You can go to Chicago. And maybe Detroit.
I know those are the places that conventionally have the best pizza to us. But I'm just saying, like, you can drop me. I could be walking down the street. Somebody could drive up slow in a van. Somebody opens the van. They club me in the back of the head. They throw something over my head. They kidnap me. They bring me somewhere. I just hear a lot of rustling and bustling. I don't move because I don't know exactly what's going on. And I don't want to stoke anything and wind up dead. So I don't say anything. I take a 10-hour ride with these people. I hear their conversation. I listen for clues in case I can make a break and I can call the police.
Okay.
Okay? But I just take the ride and they end up dumping me somewhere. I roll out. I'm famished.
I love this story hydrated. So far. I love that you've been clubbed and dumped already. Yeah. I love it.
Okay? All of a sudden, I hear tires screech. I'm still, no one's around. I feel fit that I could take the burlap sack off my head. I'm starving. I don't even know where I am. I'll Google pizza and have it delivered to me, wherever they drop me, no matter what. Doesn't that say something to you about pizza?
You're wrong.
I don't mean the fact
you know how
I'm
many...
saying pizza is available everywhere at all
hands
hours.
Down. Fine. What's that a, doesn't what's mean
number,
it's good.
What's the number
that
one thing?
Mean it's good.
What's the number one thing that you think
and
worldwide,
I will tell you this.
Let me finish. What's the number one you think? What's the number one thing you think worldwide, cumulatively, in the history of time, that has been delivered the most to people's homes? Think about that. More people. Over,
milk.
No.
Milk.
Milk. More people. Milk. More people in the world today than anything else have had the desire
so
to be like. Pick up that phone. I need somebody to
hold
bring me pizza.
Hold on a second, but I will tell you something. You are right that pizza is the most deliverable food, and it is the most available food at all times. And you know what? Because of that, I have never been burned more with a food tasting like crap than pizza. You know how many years I've been on the road doing comedy, and I've sat in a hotel room at 2 a.m., and the only option was a pizza place in some state that wasn't good at pizza, and I ordered it, and I was sitting there going, I just spent $25, and I ate three bites of this, and it's disgusting.
Americans eat approximately 100 acres of pizza each day, 350 slices a second. 36% of all pizza orders want their pizza. That's what I was going
to
say.
I'll take you back to Snickers Kit Kat, babe. Don't get arrogant, because Snickers runs the world, and they lost to Kit Kat.
You're right. Yeah. You're right. But all I'm saying is, you keep talking about how you got burned on the side of a road and when you were doing stand-up.
No. You were on the side of the road. I was in a hotel.
No, but I mean a hotel on the side of the road.
Yeah.
A hotel on the side of the road.
Well, no, on a regular road, maybe a major thoroughfare.
Wherever you are, if you're getting burned with the pizza, you're getting burned with the pasta.
That's not true.
Yes, it is.
That's not true.
Yes, it is.
That's not true.
Don't give me the argument that you're getting pizza roadside in a Midwestern town in a hotel on the side of the road. Of course it's going to suck.
No.
So's the pasta.
No.
I've been burned by pasta. You think I haven't been burned by pasta? I'll take my shirt off, show you all the burns.
Taste buds, they come into the mic, talking about the food they hate, talking about the food they like. Two fools gonna fight, but only one food can be right. Taste buds, man, yeah, they come into the mic, I'm talking taste buds.